Good morning. Headlines for today's news bulletin are: MedUni Viana develops new technique for eye imaging, an exercise pill developed for heart failure patients, researchers transform skin cells into insulin-making cells, researchers in Sweden develop new ultra-fast antibiotic resistance test. Moving on to the main news now. MedUni Viana develops new technique for eye imaging. Austria's Medical University of Viana researchers from the Center for Medical Physics and Biomedical Technology have developed a new optical coherence tomography technique called line field OCT to enable better three-dimensional imaging of the eye's cellular structure. OCT is a high-resolution live imaging technique designed to allow early identification of retinal diseases such as age-related macular degeneration, diabetes-related conditions, glaucoma, and vascular occlusions. It employs a process called optical biopsy that uses light to produce high-resolution cross-sectional images of biological tissues. When it completes the necessary clinical studies, MedUni Viana intends to commercialize the new OCT technology in partnership with German firm Carl Zeiss Meditech. An exercise pill developed for heart failure patients. According to latest research, scientists at the Ottawa University in Canada have come up with a pill that can mimic the effects of regular exercise. This could be significantly beneficial to heart failure patients. For this study, the researchers used a protein called cardiotrophin 1 and attempted to see if it could help stimulate the growth of new muscle cells in the heart. The protein was found to promote heart cell growth in the experimental laboratory rodents in a similar way that exercise increases heart strength. Researchers have explained that this exciting new find is still in nascent stages, and more studies, especially on humans, are needed before this can be available for use. They concluded that the protein cardiotrophin 1 can produce healthy and beneficial remodeling of the heart. First clinical trials on humans can be expected in 3 to 4 years of time. Researchers transform skin cells into insulin-making cells. Norwegian researchers are one step closer to cure diabetes by making insulin-producing cells from skin cells. Researchers at the University of Bergen have transformed skin puncture cells from diabetes patients into insulin-producing cells using stem cell techniques. The researchers' aim is to transplant these cells under the skin of people with diabetes. In the long run, the researchers' goal is to replace insulin swords and blood sugar measurements with insulin-secreting cells capable of automatically secreting insulin in response to blood sugar level. This can become possible by implanting a capsule with tailor-made cells in each diabetes patient. Researchers in Sweden develop new ultra-fast antibiotic resistance test. Researchers at Uppsala University in Sweden have developed a new method for very rapidly determining whether infection-causing bacteria are resistant or susceptible to antibiotics. The test is fast enough to enable a patient to take the right antibiotic home from the health center straight after the first appointment. The test is primarily intended for urinary tract infections. The fast test method is based on sensitive optical and analytical techniques developed to study the behavior of individual bacteria. Monitoring whether individual bacteria grow in the presence of antibiotics that is resistant or not, that is susceptible, reveals their resistance or susceptibility within a few minutes. The detection method is now being developed by an Uppsala company, AstraZeneca Diagnostics, AB, into a user-friendly product. The company expects to have an automated test for urinary tract infections within a few years. Thank you.